Hi, my name is Ed Newbold. I'm a wildlife artist at the Pike Place Market. And the title of this movie is The Jens Klinner Disruption. But first, this is Emmy Lou Harris singing a Lucinda Williams song about suicide, and it's against suicide. Of course, my friend at the market, Paul Stricker, was listening to this song. And he asked me a question about it, and I was explaining it. I said, this is a song against suicide. And he said, that's not the effect it has on me. So anyway, so I'll turn it down just a little in case it's not the effect it has on you. The Jens Klinner Disruption. Now, disruption has a bad connotation in some ways. But disruption can be good. My last movie was about all the new paintings I was doing and how I was excited about them. But all that's out the window. I'm finishing old paintings now. Jens Klinner is my longest term collector. I started collecting back in the 80s and he asked me to look around. He likes the old stuff I used to do better. Understandable. I was young. I was a young man then. I'm a 71-year-old now. But he asked me to look around and find old stuff and see what's. So I found five paintings that I'm gonna try to finish. You gotta finish them if you want to sell a painting. And I have a painting here that's 42 years old. This is this one. It's Pine Martin. And it was around, I started in 1912 in 1981. So it was around when my dad came to visit, and he picked this one out of the 12 paintings I had in my apartment at that time. He said, that's the best one. And so I've worked on it now every decade since for 42 years. I think it was pretty good when I got it done in 81. But in the interim period for a long time, they didn't have these fluorescent paints where you can bring things back a little bit in terms of lightness. I think I dropped the intensity down and made the painting a little too dark in the 90s and the 2010s. You know, I didn't work on it all 42 years, but I've worked on it once or twice a decade, you know, for a while. I get excited to work on it again. And but anyway, this is what it looks like now. It's Pine Martin. If this is in the weasel family, some people say, oh, that looks like a rat or something. I consider it an extremely gorgeous animal, but it hunts. It's an arboreal hunter of Douglas squirrels is what it is, or red squirrels in the boreal forest. Now, so this is not nearly as old of a painting. I started this, it says here, fourth finish, 7/8/2007. So I was already on my fourth finish then. And I said it October 1, 2009, finish. 07 finish. Yeah, anyway, I've got 2006 start. Oh, here it is. July 31st, 2006. So this is a new painting by my standards. Started in this century. Hey, this is Anacortes Ferry Dock, and I've had a problem with this painting ever since I began it. I think I've worked on it again in the last since I promised Jens, since I promised Jens I would look through these. I got more light in it, and I worked on the perspective on some of this. I made a lot of subtle changes, but for the first time I really like it myself. I hope I'm holding this high enough there to see. That's All Aboard for Anacortes. It's the ferry dock at Orcas Island. Now, this is a painting here that's pretty old. I don't know how old. Oh, it's begun summer 2011. So that's also a fairly new painting, and I had an Osprey in here for about a decade. And I changed it to an eagle, and I thought I ruined it. But I looked at it, and I thought, well, actually, the eagle is a stronger element in the composition, and it kind of looks almost like you're up close to this eagle, like the eagle doesn't know you're there. That is a female eagle with a Roman nose. You can tell eagles apart by their gender, by looking if it has a songbird beak. It's a male, smaller animal. The female has a, if you see an eagle that just appears to be huge, that's almost always a female, and they have a Roman nose. And I painted that Roman nose there. And I kind of like the eagle okay. I might have to work on that a little bit more before I say it's finished. And then this is a painting that I definitely have to work on more. This is a painting I found, and I didn't like it. I have to fix the proportionality of the cougar. It's a cougar walking on railroad tracks up by up in the Skagit. I found the scene somewhere in the Skagit, up around Nehalem or somewhere like that. It's a little wetland by the Route 2 or by the road or by one of those. I forget which highway goes by, which town's up there. This is the craziest painting. Well, I have a painting of Winslow, Edward Hopper's Nighthawks with a nighthawk in it, but this is a painting. I call this painting Mondrian Takes Up Birding. And these are Western sandpipers they're taking off. This was a painting that's never seen the light of day in terms of me printing it in the store or anything. I started it in, it doesn't say. But anyway, I'm gonna work on this a little bit more and put it out as a poster. And so those are the five ones I could find so far. We don't have a big, I've got a lot of paintings in this. Still, I haven't even looked at yet. It's not that we have a big house, it's that it's crammed with paintings. So, and a lot of them are starts, and I've got to plow through a whole lot of false starts and to find some things. Hey, but anyway, those are the five paintings. I'm going to try to get those out on the originals page of the website, so anyone will be able to buy them at ednewbold.com. And my store is at Pike Place Market at First and Pike. Thank you very kindly.